कैरियर रिलेटेड, योर सिलेक्शन रिलेटेड, एग्जाम स्ट्रेटेजी रिलेटेड डाउट्स। ओके, सो वी विल स्टार्ट अवर क्लास। या जेनिफर इज देयर एंड शिखा इज देयर। ओके,
यस सर, आई एम देयर।
या यू आर हियर, आई नो बेटा। सो वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग, वी हैव ऑलमोस्ट कंप्लीटेड दिस मोशन इन स्टेट लाइन चैप्टर एंड यू विल बी हैविंग अ टेस्ट है। यू विल बी हैविंग अ टेस्ट ऑन संडे। दिस संडे यू विल बी हैविंग एन ऑनलाइन टेस्ट रिलेटेड टू वट वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड सो फार। सो वी हैव कवर्ड मोशन इन मंडी। डू यू
यस
रिमेंबर द
सर,
कंसेप्ट और नॉट? जेनिफर, शिखा, रूपाली, यू रिमेंबर द कंसेप्ट दैट आर लर्न टिल नाउ? ओके, सो आई विल जस्ट फास्ट फॉरवर्ड दिस चैप्टर है ना, सो यू कैन लिसन इट क्वाइटली और मे बी यू कैन आस्क योर डाउट्स ऑल्सो, सो दैट इट विल बी अ रिविजन, फास्ट पेस्ड रिविजन फॉर दिस चैप्टर एंड देन वी विल प्रोसीड टू अवर नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द सिलेबस। सो हेयर वी लर्न अबाउट मोशन एंड रेस्ट, राइट? सो आई विल बी आस्किंग डाउट्स ऑल्सो, आई विल बी आस्किंग अ फ्यू क्वेश्चन टू यू। या
रूपाली, आपको मतलब हमें आपसे सिर्फ दो चीजें पूछनी थी कि आपकी फर्स्ट वीक में थोड़ा सा अटेंडेंस डाउन थी, क्या इसका रीजन आप बता पाओगे कि कोई इशू तो नहीं है बच्चे आपको? रूपाली साहू के नाम से जिस बच्चे ने क्लास को ज्वाइन किया, आपकी लास्ट वीक में अटेंडेंस 50% थी, बट अभी तो आपने क्लासेस ज्वाइन की इस वीक में, तो क्या आप रीजन अपडेट कर पाएंगे लास्ट वीक के लिए? कोई इशू तो नहीं है बच्चे आपको कि लिंक में कोई इशू होता हो, क्लास को ज्वाइन करने में इशू होता हो, नेटवर्क इशू टाइप होता हो आपको?
नो सर,
ओके ओके ओके। और
स्कूल
बच्चे आप
एग्जाम।
ना व्हाट्सएप पे हमारे साथ कनेक्टेड रहिएगा, आपको कोई भी इशू है तो प्लीज आप ना आस्क कीजिएगा कि डायरेक्ट कॉल कीजिएगा। ठीक है, ठीक है सर, अभी आप स्टार्ट कर लीजिए सर।
सो गायत्री ऑल्सो ज्वाइंट, शिखा, जेनिफर एंड रूपाली। ओके गाइज, सो टुडे वी विल, वट वी विल ट्राई, वी विल ट्राई टू लर्न टुगेदर है ना। यू हैव टू पार्टिसिपेट इन द क्लास, यू हैव टू अनम्यूट अगेन एंड अगेन एंड आंसर माई क्वेश्चन, सो दैट इट विल बी टू वे कम्युनिकेशन है ना। सो वाई वी आर हेयर, वी नो दैट ना, वाई वी ऑल आर हेयर, बताओ बच्चे। वी आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर अवर नीट एग्जाम है ना, एंड दैट लर्निंग प्रोसेस शुड बी बोरिंग और इट शुड बी एक्साइटिंग, इट शुड बी एक्साइटिंग ना। शिखा अनम्यूटेड, इट शुड बी एक्साइटिंग है ना। सो I told you the rules in the class, na? In the very first class, I told you the rules. We have only two major rules. The first one is learning and the second one is enjoyment in the class. So we should learn and we should learn it happily. And that can only happen when there is a two-way communication. Right or wrong, beta?
Yes, sir.
Hey, you can unmute yourself. Since we are only three, four students, so we can keep ourselves unmuted. Okay, so in motion in 1D, I started with motion, then rest, then we laid down that there is no such thing as absolute motion or absolute rest. We negated these both terms, then we proceeded to position vector. Position vector, R, it is generally represented with small letter r with an arrowhead over it, and it represents the position of any general point P with respect to the origin of the reference frame. Then we proceeded by defining 1D, 2D and 3D motion. Then we differentiated distance and displacement. We defined distance as the length of the actual part traveled and displacement is a vector quantity which represents the shortest possible distance between the two points. And that vector is pointing from the initial position to the final position. Then position vector we defined, we defined displacement vector. Displacement vector was defined as a vector, the tail of which the vector is placed at the initial point and the head is placed at the final point, and the length of the vector represents the magnitude of displacement vector. We learned it. Then we solved problems on distance and displacement. Then we defined speed. What is speed? Speed is of two types, which two types we discussed beta Jennifer, which were the two types of speed that we discussed in the class? Yeah, Shikha.
So we discussed average speed and instantaneous speed.
Average speed and instantaneous speed, okay. Okay. What is average speed? Average speed kya hota hai beta? Average speed is at a interval of time. Like if I ask you that give me the speed when the object is displaced from position I to position F at between time t is equal to 2 second and t is equal to 4 second. So I am providing you the interval that t equals to 2 and t equals to 4. So in such cases we find average speed. And if I ask you the value of speed at a particular instant of time, say at t equals to 1 second, then what we say, it is instantaneous speed. And likewise we discussed for velocity. Velocity is also of two types, instantaneous velocity and average velocity. So instantaneous velocity is at a particular instant of time and average is during a time interval, right? So we defined speed and velocity. Which one of these is a vector quantity out of speed and velocity? Which
velocity.
Velocity is a vector quantity, right? Can velocity have a negative value? Can velocity take a negative value, beta?
Yes, sir.
Yes, because since displacement vector can take a negative value, so velocity can also take a negative value, right? Then we defined the formulas for both average velocity and instantaneous velocity. Average velocity is between time instant, that a finite time instant, which is larger, large enough to take TF and TI, right? So this delta T is large enough. So there is a finite time difference like t equals to 2 to t equals to 4. So 2 second is a large enough time interval. In those cases, we found out average velocity. And if I say that t equals to 1 second, what we do? We take a very small time interval around t equals to 1 second. And then we find out delta s by delta t. And that we receive that instantaneous velocity is nothing but the first differential of displacement vector. Using this concept, we solved a few questions. Here we found out the displacement vector is given. We found out velocity as dx by dt, right?
Yes.
Then we proceeded. We found out average speed, instantaneous speed. In the same way, we found out average speed and instantaneous speed. Just we replaced displacement with distance. Distance covered, total distance covered upon total time taken is average speed. And instantaneous speed is distance covered in a very small time interval. If this delta t is very small, this delta t tending to zero, then we can say that this magnitude of ds by dt is nothing but speed at that very particular instant of time, right? Then we solved questions again, and then we proceeded to graphs. So graphs, you have to help me out on this graph. This, which type of graph is this? Displacement and position and time, or displacement time graph, right? So on this graph, what is the slope representing, beta? Rupali, batao. Slope kya represent karta hai? What does the slope on xt graph represent? Gayatri, what does the slope of xt graph represent? Hey, any student who knows the answer, just raise their hand or unmute and tell me the answer. What does the xt graph slope on xt graph represent? Gayatri, Jennifer, Rupali.
So average speed.
Hey, are you there? Just raise your hand. I don't see you in the class. I think you are not here. You just joined the class and left. Rupali is here. Shikha is also here. Gayatri, raise your hand. Jennifer. Yeah, I think Jennifer left the class, huh? Okay. So, So, slope on xt graph is m, and that is tangent of theta. What is tan theta? From geometry, we know tan theta is perpendicular upon base, right? So, if we draw a triangle here, just look it again, beta. If we draw a triangle such that perpendicular is equal to delta x and base is equal to delta t. So we can find out this theta value. What will be this theta value? We can find out tangent of theta, and that will be delta x by delta t. And we know that delta x by delta t is nothing but velocity, right? Slope is equal to tan theta, and that is delta x by delta t. We know it, that perpendicular by base is tangent theta. So perpendicular is delta x and base is delta t. So slope is velocity. So theta will be nothing but tan inverse of delta x by delta t, right? So we can find out theta value. Similarly, if the graph is variable, right? If this graph is variable slope, so what we can say, that velocity is changing or fixed?
Velocity is changing.
Velocity is changing, right? So velocity is increasing or decreasing, beta? Slope is increasing as I move on time axis. Slope is increasing, right? The slope is increasing. That means velocity is increasing with time, right?
Yes, sir.
So acceleration is positive. If the slope is increasing with time, we can say that acceleration is positive.
Non-zero
as well as positive acceleration, beta. Since velocity is increasing, that means acceleration value is positive. Then we solve the question based upon area under the curve. So area under the curve on a XT graph represents what? I told you, area under any graph, right? Since it is a XT graph, we can find out area under the curve is equal to x-axis multiplied by y-axis, or vertical axis into horizontal axis. What does displacement into time gives us? What does displacement into time gives us?
Velocity.
Displacement into time.
Speed.
Displacement. We know that speed, velocity is equal to displacement upon time. If we multiply displacement by time, what we will get? I multiply both direction with t square, right? So I will multiply here also with t square and here also t square. So do we get any quantity as t square into velocity? Do we have anything? No. X into t is velocity into t square. So we don't have any physical quantity which represent v into t square. So slope on XT graph does not give any physical quantity. So we are only, so area under the curve on any XT graph does not give us any physical quantity. Slope gives us velocity. Okay. Then we solved the question of speed based upon the slope on XT graph. Then we proceeded further and we introduced uniform and non-uniform motion. So uniform motion is something where velocity is batao.
Constant.
Where velocity is constant. Uniform motion is where velocity is constant. V is equal to constant. And non-uniform is when velocity is
not constant.
Variable
or not constant, right? So velocity is variable. Right. Okay. So position time graph of a constant velocity motion. XT graph of a constant velocity motion is a straight line with constant slope throughout, right? So constant slope throughout means velocity is constant, and this is the graph of constant velocity motion or uniform motion. And in the second one, we know that velocity is increasing with time, so it is a graph of uniform motion or non-uniform motion?
Non-uniform.
Right? Okay. Then we discussed about area under the curve on velocity time graph. What does area under the curve on velocity time graph represent, beta? Area under the curve, be it on any graph, area under the curve, AUC, is equal to vertical axis into horizontal axis. Velocity into time is what? Velocity multiplied by time. Kya represent karta hai?
Displacement,
right? Theek hai, shabas. Okay, so area under the curve represents displacement on velocity time graph. So we calculated these things, and we also introduced the thing that integration is nothing but area. Area is represented by integration. Integration why? Because we have to take finite steps. and we calculate the area of all these strips. We add the areas of all such strips and we ultimately get this bigger area. And doing this will give us a displacement, total displacement of the object, right? So integration is distance, integration on velocity time graph represents displacement. Okay. If we are only concerned about magnitude part, right? I also showed you a graph that if this is XT graph, this is, sorry, VT graph. If I say that this is the graph, right? So there is a positive part of area, which is positive, and this is negative. If I take these areas, maybe we can say that this area is A1 and the second one is A2. If I substitute, if I take the only magnitude part of these areas, like I add A1 plus A2. So A2 is negative, right? If I only take the magnitude of these areas, what we will get? We will get distance covered. And if I take the areas with their signs, like A1 minus A2, I'm adding the areas, but A2 is negative value. So what we are doing exactly, A1 plus second area with the negative sign. So what we will get? We will get net displacement. Distance is only magnitude part and displacement is with sign. Okay. Then we introduce the concept of average acceleration. Average acceleration is what? Change in velocity divided by time taken for that change. So average velocity is equal to average acceleration is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity divided by TF minus TI. Right? Then we introduce instantaneous acceleration. So if this delta t is very small, it is tending to zero, then we can say that this acceleration is, we are talking about at a particular instant, and this will be nothing but first differential of velocity vector, right? So this is acceleration. Then we found out average acceleration between time t equals to 2 and 4 using this plot. And how we found out? By using tangent of theta between t equals to 2 and 4. So slope of the line is nothing but average acceleration. Then I showed you this thing, if we start with displacement, I differentiate it once, we will arrive at velocity. I again differentiate, we will arrive at acceleration. And if the acceleration is given, we integrate this acceleration with respect to dt and we will get velocity. Again, integration will give us displacement, right? So we keep on differentiating, we will be getting velocity, then acceleration. And if I integrate starting from acceleration, first I will get velocity function, then again integration will give us displacement function or position function. We solved a question based upon vector notation of displacement vector. Then we solved a few questions based upon this velocity concept, right? Then we introduced the relative velocity concept. You know, velocity of A with respect to B is velocity of A minus velocity of B. Right? Velocity of A with respect to B, A ka velocity, B ke respect mein is VA minus VB. VBA matlab velocity of B with respect to A, so VB minus VA. Then we introduced three equations of motions, you know, and applied those three equations of motion on the gravitation thing. Right? So what were the two assumptions that we discussed while discussing gravitation? Batao beta. Jennifer, what are the two assumptions that I told you that during calculation of problems based upon acceleration due to gravity, what are the two things that we need to take in account? Jennifer?
Acceleration of gravity negative.
Gayatri, aap batao beta. Abhi puchhenge, misba aap se puchhenge beta. Theek hai, Tamanna, Gayatri. Jennifer, Tamanna, Gayatri.
Sir, previous class I not attend, sir.
Previous class?
I was not attend, sir.
So you should attend every class, na beta, otherwise you will lose the concepts. How will you write today's Sunday's exam?
Sir, I went to function, sir, so I can't attend. So,
so, you, यू शुड हैव रिमेम्बर्ड, यू शुड हैव रिवाइज इट यूजिंग द क्लास रिकॉर्डिंग्स ना, सो यू डू इट बाय. ओके तमन्ना. तमन्ना बोरीचा. Jennifer, guys, you, if your no, name is called, you should unmute, na? You should have respect for your teacher. Venisha. Venisha. If you don't know the answer, just unmute and say ki we need to revise that. We can revise that again. Hello. Okay, so okay, Misbah, now you tell beta. What are the two assumptions that we discussed?
The equation of motion applicable because it is uniform.
Because it is uniformly accelerated motion, hai na? Yahan pe acceleration will be constant, right? If the acceleration is constant, that means we are talking about uniformly accelerated motion. And while deriving these three equations, the first one, second one, and third one, what was the core assumption? That the acceleration here is constant. And if acceleration is constant, what we say? It is uniformly accelerated motion. When we said na ki uniform velocity motion, so that was uniform motion. And if we say uniformly accelerated motion, that means beta, acceleration is constant, right? Now listen to the two assumptions again. The first one is, when we are calculating the problems based upon acceleration due to gravity or gravitational force, we always take vertically upward direction as batao.
Positive.
We take this direction as positive direction. And another assumption is, another thing that will always be applicable is that acceleration due to gravity always acts in upward direction. Yeah, acceleration due to gravity acts in downward direction. So while putting the value of g in the equations, what we will take, minus g or plus g?
Minus g.
Since we have assumed that the vertically upward direction is positive, so while substituting the value of g, we will substitute it as minus g, right, beta? Okay. Another thing that we discussed is, like, just I am giving you a problem. Give me the value, right? See, suppose there is a particle, there is a mass at some height h from the ground. It is at some height h from the ground. This is the initial position I, and this particle after some time t reaches at height equals to zero, h equals to zero at final position, right? So this is the final position and this one is the initial position, right, beta? Now while moving from initial position to final position, in which direction does the particle displace? Upward or downward?
Downward.
And the downward direction is negative or positive?
Negative.
So while substituting the value of s, suppose I give you the equation, s is equal to ut plus half a t square, right? So we will have to substitute the value of s here and a here. So what we will substitute s as, minus h or plus h?
Minus h.
Since the particle has displaced in the negative direction mein displacement hua hai. So while substituting the value of s, we will place it as minus h. Okay. Suppose the initially the particle is at zero velocity. So we will substitute u as zero.
Zero.
Okay. Now 1/2. What will be the value of a? Minus g or plus g?
Minus g.
Because gravity is always downward acting. So downward acting things are substituted as negative. So we will substitute minus g and t square. So you get this idea, na? Ki what are the values that we have to substitute? Then we solved this question. We found out time of flight, maximum height reached by the particle, landing speed of the particle, we discussed it. Just for the confirmation, can you solve this question again, beta? You try it again. Like how many students know the answer to this question who have already solved this? Can you raise your hand? Sikha, have you already solved this question, beta? Mishba, Sikha, Gayatri, Jennifer?
Have
you
already?
Okay,
yes, sir.
You solved it, na? Sikha solved, I remember. Sikha was there in the class. Okay. Gayatri, have you solved this one, beta?
No, sir.
So we will try this question again, right? It seems that aapko concept abhi bhool gaye ho, hai na? So we will try this question again. So read the question and then I will show you the solution and then we will figure out whether we are solving it correctly or not. A ball is thrown upwards from the top of a tower of height 60 meter with a velocity of 20 meter per second. Find the landing speed on the ground. A ball is thrown upward to the top of a tower, from the top of a tower. Yeah, Sikha knows the answer, right? So from the top of the tower, right? So this is the initial position of the ball. This is the initial position. What is the value of h at initial position? What is the value of h at the initial position, beta?
60.
And what is the value of h at the final position? What will be the final position? Ultimately, the ball will hit the ground. So, yes, h will be 0. H will be 0. So, initially, height is 60 meters and finally, it will reach to the h equals to 0. So, the ball displaced in the negative direction or the positive direction?
Negative direction.
So what? While substituting the value of s, we will substitute positive 60 or minus 60, beta?
Minus 60.
We will substitute it as minus 60 meter, right? Okay. What is the initial velocity of the ball? It is projected with velocity of 20 meter per second in the upward or downward direction? Which direction we?
Upward.
So we will substitute u as positive or negative?
Positive
20 meters. Okay. And what we will substitute a? A is equal to minus g or plus g?
Minus g.
Minus g always. So it will be minus g. And we can take the value of g as 10 meter per second. Since it is not given in the question, we will simplify our solution. We will take it as 10 meter per second. Okay. Okay. Now we have to find out what? Find the landing speed. So we have to find out final velocity of this ball when it hits the ground. So we have to find out v, which we will choose this equation. V square minus u square is equal to 2as, right? So v square minus u square is equal to 2as. We will substitute the values as we recorded the values. We will substitute them as it is. So we have to find out the value of v square. We will take v square as it is. What is the value of u, beta? Positive 20.
So we will
positive 20 square is equal to 2 into what is the value of acceleration?
Minus 10.
What is the value of displacement s?
Minus 60.
Right?
-60.
Now we have figured out that what is happening in the problem. We have taken the assumptions and we are substituting the values as it is. Right? Now we just have to solve this equation. So v square माइनस 20 स्क्वायर क्या होता है 400 इज इक्वल टू 2 इनटू 10 इनटू 60 क्या होगा बेटा
1200
राइट दिस 400 विल गो टू द राइट वी स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू 1600 तो वी का वैल्यू क्या आएगा प्लस माइनस अंडर रूट 1600 एंड दैट विल बी प्लस माइनस ऑफ 40 सो व्हिच वन व्हिच वैल्यू विल यू चूज पॉजिटिव 40 और माइनस 40
Minus 40.
Since we know that the final velocity is in the downward direction. So downward direction is always negative direction.
Negative.
So we can find, we can say that the v velocity vector is minus 40. In the which direction? Vertical direction is I cap or J cap?
J cap.
So minus 40 J cap. Can we place the units also? Yes, we know that the velocity units are given as meter per second. Take it as minus 40 j cap meter per second. So velocity vector we have found out. Okay, if we have to find out only magnitude, what we can do? we can say that we only need magnitude of this vector. So what we can see, it is 40 meters per second, because we will omit the sign convention, then we will just take the magnitude part. Okay beta, these are the concept that you have to remember, since it is not asked in the question explicitly, but we have to take these things into account, so that when such questions arise at our like exposure, then we can just take that question and solve it according to the concept that we are learning from these little small questions, right? Okay, then we solved a similar question when the balloon was dropped from a when a stone is dropped from a balloon moving in the upward direction. Okay, then we calculated displacement in nth second. So this formula you have to remember, you can write it somewhere. If you are making the notes for short notes, you can write it somewhere. Okay, I have provided the short notes for M1D also. Have you revised through that, beta? Miss Ba, Shikha, Jennifer, Gayatri?
No, sir.
You, okay. Okay, so we calculated the value of displacement in nth second, and this thing you don't need to remember. No, no need to solve this question. Okay. Now, there are few more questions related to these concepts that you can take as a homework and solve them. Solution to every question is already provided in the slides, right? So I've already shared the notes, beta. So there are few questions. These five questions are for homework. You can solve them and match your answer with the solutions provided, right? So there are, these are the questions and these are the solutions. Solution to homework and assignment. So there are many questions and you can take them as homework, and there are solutions provided to every question in the slides. Right, beta. Okay, now we will discuss the things based upon the short notes. Right, we will discuss the short notes of this M1D chapter that I will be sharing. I have already shared, I will share it again also. So you can revise the complete chapter through these short notes of M1D. So these are the notes that will be shared with you. Motion in one dimensions. My screen share is paused, right? So, so we will be revising through these short notes from motion in 1D, right? Here, every definition that you require, theoretical definitions and the related formulas and quick tricks are already mentioned in these, so it can help you as a quick revision document for your studies, right? Kinematics, distance, displacement, then velocity, average velocity, formula for average velocity, formula for instantaneous velocity, then average speed, instantaneous speed, average acceleration, right? Instantaneous acceleration. These are all formulas that are already provided in the notes. Then three equations of motion, v is equal to u plus at, s equals to ut plus half at square, v square minus u square is equal to 2as, and the formula for nth second, displacement in nth second. These are the important formulas that you have to remember for this particular chapter, right? Then graphs based upon slope and area under the curve concept, like this is displacement time graph. Can you say, tell me what is the velocity of this particle, beta?
Zero.
Jennifer, can you help me out? Why the velocity is zero, beta? Gayatri, why the velocity of zero is zero, beta?
Sir, because that part, the object is a cyst.
Because? Why the velocity is zero?
Sir, the
object is fixed. Okay, Miss Bai, you tell me, beta.
Sir, because the particle is at rest.
Because the particle is at rest. एंड व्हेन वी मूव ऑन टाइम एक्सिस वी सी दैट द डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज नॉट चेंजिंग, है ना। ओके मिसबा, आपका नाम मिसबा ही है ना बेटा या दूसरे
यस
आईडी
सर।
से ज्वाइन किया? ओके शिखा, आपका नाम शिखा है राइट? शिखा दुबे। सो वी नो दैट पार्टिकल इज इन यूनिफॉर्म मोशन, तो यूनिफॉर्म मोशन मीन्स कॉन्स्टेंट स्लोप ऑन एक्स टी ग्राफ और कॉन्स्टेंट वेलोसिटी, सो इट इज़ यूनिफॉर्म मोशन। देन दिस इज एक्स नॉट ग्राफ ऑफ एक्स टी, सो डिस्प्लेसमेंट टाइम हेयर ऑल्सो द स्लोप इज कॉन्स्टेंट। ओके शिखा, वी डिस्कस दिस, यू ऑलरेडी अटेंडेड द क्लास विद दिस डिस्कशन ना फॉर शॉर्ट नोट्स शिखा?
यस सर।
या मिशबा, आपने अटेंड नहीं किया, कोई नहीं, वी विल डिस्कस इट अगेन एंड देन वी विल प्रोसीड टू न्यूटन लॉज ऑफ मोशन। ठीक है, ओके। सो इनिशियल वेलोसिटी राइट, दीज आर द ग्राफ्स फॉर पोजिशन टाइम मैंशनड इन दिस डॉक्यूमेंट। देन वेलोसिटी टाइम ग्राफ्स, एरिया अंडर द कर्व क्या रिप्रेजेंट करेगा और स्लोप क्या रिप्रेजेंट करेगा, यू कैन गेट दैट आइडिया फ्रॉम हेयर। देर आर सम इम्पॉसिबल ग्राफ्स दैट आर प्रोवाइडेड एंड द रीजन वाई दीज आर इम्पॉसिबल इज ऑलरेडी देयर, यू कैन रीड इट हेयर। And then motion under gravity, the equations, the three equations of motion as per the assumptions of motion under the gravity, right? Then there is something called as relative velocity. So velocity of A with respect to B is already we have discussed, that velocity of A minus velocity of B. Velocity of acceleration of A with respect to B is acceleration of A minus acceleration of B. Here VA and VB are velocity of A is with respect to ground, velocity of B is also with respect to ground, acceleration of A is with respect to ground and acceleration of B is also with respect to ground. Right, so these are the formulas. Misba, you can read out them. Sikha, you already have, I believe you already had a revision of this thing, and I will be sharing this thing in the group again. Right, now we will start our new chapter, which is Newton's laws of motion. न्यूटन्स लॉज ऑफ मोशन, ठीक है बेटा। सो बिफोर वी प्रोसीड वी हैव टू डिस्कस व्हाट इज फोर्स, है ना। सो फोर्स क्या होता है बेटा? मिसबा, शिखा, गायत्री, एनीबडी ऑफ यू हु विश टू डिफाइन व्हाट इज फोर्स, ऑलरेडी स्क्रीन पे लिखा हुआ है, यहाँ से पढ़ सकते हो आप। फोर्स क्या होगा बताओ, व्हाट इज फोर्स बेटा? अ पुश और पुल दैट चेंजेस और टेंड्स टू चेंज द स्टेट ऑफ अ मोशन, ठीक है। तो पुश या पुल, है ना, पुश करोगे कंप्रेसिव फोर्स लगाओगे या टेंसाइल फोर्स लगाओगे। अब देखो, आप एक इमेजिन करना एक सिचुएशन, आपके हाथ में एक बलून है, आपने बलून लिया, उसको हवा भर दी, फुला दिया, अब हाथ में पकड़ा, अब आप उसको दबाओगे तो चेंज होगा उसका शेप बेटा? चेंज होगा?
यस
यस।
अब उस बलून को रिप्लेस करके, ये बॉल है, मेरे हाथ को देखो, ये बॉल है। अब यहाँ पे मुझे कंपैरेटिवली ज्यादा फोर्स लगाना पड़ेगा इफ आई नीड टू चेंज द शेप ऑफ दिस बॉल। यस, अब मैं इस बॉल को भी रिप्लेस करके यहाँ पे एक पत्थर ले लेता हूँ, क्या ले लेता हूँ, स्टोन। क्या उस स्टोन को मैं कंप्रेस कर पाऊंगा अपने हाथों से?
नो सर,
नहीं कर पाऊंगा।
No,
तो फोर्स तो लग रहा है ना, तब मैं कंप्रेस करना चाह रहा हूँ तो मैं फोर्स तो लगा रहा हूँ, बट क्या इफेक्ट नजर आ रहा है बेटा? नहीं आ रहा, इफेक्ट नजर नहीं आ रहा। इफ स्टोन मेरे हाथ में, इफ आई हैव अ स्टोन इन माई हैंड एंड ट्राई टू कंप्रेस दैट स्टोन विद द ग्रिप ऑफ माई हैंड, तो क्या होगा? विल देयर बी सम ऑब्जर्वेबल चेंजेस इन द शेप ऑफ द स्टोन? नो। सो फोर्स पहले मैं अप्लाई कर रहा था इन द केस ऑफ बलून ऑल्सो, इन द केस ऑफ स्टोन ऑल्सो। तो इन केस ऑफ बलून आई कैन सी द चेंजेस, है ना, आई कैन सी द चेंजेस ऑन द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ फोर्स, बट इन केस ऑफ स्टोन आई कैन नॉट सी चेंजेस। सो डेफिनेशन पढ़ो अभी। अ पुश और पुल दैट चेंजेस और टेंड्स टू चेंज द स्टेट, है ना, आइदर इट विल चेंज एज इन केस ऑफ बलून और इट विल टेंड टू चेंज, ऐसा इट विल ट्राई टू चेंज द स्टेट, है ना। तो एज इन केस ऑफ स्टोन वी आर ट्राइंग टू चेंज द स्टेट बट वी डोंट सी द रिजल्ट्स। ओके, सो दैट इज द केस फॉर शेप, बट फॉर मोशन, मोशन आई विल शो यू अनदर एग्जाम्पल। लाइक if you have to push a chair, you have a chair in the room and you have to push, so can you push it easily? You apply force on the chair and you push it easily. So the effect of force are observable. Suppose if there is a train, in the case of chair, in the case of chair, you are able to push that thing and you see the effects of force, right? You change the state of the chairs. Initially, the chair was at rest. You applied force and you moved it. So rest is converted into motion, right? So you change the state of motion. In the second case, suppose there is a train coming. Train is moving very slowly, and you try to become a superhero and you try to push that train. Will you be able to stop that one?
No, sir.
No.
No, sir.
So are you trying or you are applying force or not? Yes.
Applying.
You are applying a push. You are pushing the train, but and you are trying to change the state of the train. Are you able to change or not? No.
No.
So you are tending to change the state of the motion, है ना? The train is moving and you are tending to stop it, but you are not able to stop it, right? But still you are applying the force. So that is how we define force, कि either the force can change the state of motion or it will tend to change the state of motion, right, बेटा? Right. So change of state of motion, right? So state of motion can be changed in three ways. Either change the direction of motion. If something is moving in a particular direction, you apply force and the direction of the motion changes. कैसा होता है? When we play football, football is approaching you. You kick it. You apply a force, and then you change the direction of motion. Right or wrong? Yes. If some object is moving slowly, है ना? You push it, then it changes its speed. है ना? Magnitude of velocity changes. You change the speed of the object. That is also possible. And the shape of the object can also be changed, as we discussed in the case of balloon. So these are the three types of things that we can observe on the application of force. So we established what is force. Either it can be a push or a pull. Push तो हमने समझा. Pull कैसे होगा बेटा? If I say that कि if I hold your hand, right, and I try to pull you, so will I be able to pull you? Yes. So on the application of force, I can pull something or I can push something. Okay. Now we have established कि फोर्स क्या होता है, बट फोर्स का टाइप भी होगा. देर विल बी सम टाइप ऑफ फोर्सेज, एंड द फर्स्ट वन इज क्या लिखा है बेटा?
कॉन्टैक्ट फोर्स.
कॉन्टैक्ट फोर्स. तो कॉन्टैक्ट फोर्स, एज द नेम सेज इटसेल्फ, कि इसके लिए क्या होना चाहिए? व्हेन टू बॉडीज आर इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद ईच अदर, तो दो बॉडीज को एक दूसरे के कॉन्टेक्ट में होना जरूरी है. बॉडीज हैव टू बी इन कॉन्टेक्ट, दे हैव टू बी इन फिजिकल कॉन्टेक्ट विद ईच अदर, राइट? सो लेट अस टेक टू बॉडीज. There are two blocks. The first one is this bottom one, and the another one is this white color block. Are they in contact or not? Yes, they are in contact. I will draw this contact surface. They are in contact at this red line. Right. So there are two forces. The first one is perpendicular to the contact surface. What is that force, beta?
Normal.
The force which is perpendicular to the contact surface. Normal force. Right, and there is another force which is along the contact surface, but which is this force? Frictional force. There are two types of contact forces. One is the perpendicular to the contact surface, and that is called as normal force. And the second one is parallel to the contact surface, that is called as frictional force. So these are two types of forces, and these are called as contact forces. And for the contact forces, the object have to be in physical contact with each other. Yes, beta. There is second type of force. We discussed contact force. There is second type of force which is called as tension in a string. Have you heard of this one? Tension in a string. सुना है? Yes. अब बताओ, string जो है, what is string? So tension in a string बाद में देखेंगे. First we will define what is string. In the language of physics, what is string? बताओ बेटा.
हेलो.
यस मिशबा, आप बताओ. गायत्री आप बताओ. बताओ, बता रहे थे ना, व्हाट इज अ स्ट्रिंग?
चलो.
ओके मिशबा, आप बताओ बेटा, व्हाट इज अ स्ट्रिंग?
रो
रोप. ओके शिखा,
सर. अरो.
अ रोप. ओके ओके, कैन वी से दैट दिस इज अ स्ट्रिंग? यू कैन टेक इट एज ए एग्जाम्पल ऑफ स्ट्रिंग, अज्यूम इट एज ए स्ट्रिंग और अ रोप और
यस
अ धागा और रस्सी, कुछ भी मानो, ठीक है. सो दिस इज अ स्ट्रिंग. बट फॉर द स्ट्रिंग टू बी इफेक्टिव इन लैंग्वेज ऑफ फिजिक्स देर आर टू अजम्पशन. द फर्स्ट वन इज द स्ट्रिंग हैज टू बी, बट वी कैन से अबाउट मास, मासलेस. स्ट्रिंग हैज टू बी मासलेस, देर शुड नॉट बी सम मास इन द स्ट्रिंग. एंड द सेकेंड थिंग इज द स्ट्रिंग शुड ऑलवेज बी स्ट्रेच्ड. For the string to be effective, the string should always to be stretched, right?
Straight.
For example, just observe my two hands and this string in between, right, beta? If I try to move my, this is my right hand and this is left hand. If I try to move my left hand with the help of right hand, can I do it like this? I push the string. Is that moving my left hand? Pushing a string?
Yes.
No.
Sir.
You cannot transfer force by pushing a string. No force is transferred, right? String will slack. String ऐसे ही इकट्ठा हो जाएगा, slack कर जाएगा, right? I am trying to push my left hand with the help of right hand, but there is no motion on the left hand side, and I am moving my right hand, right? So string is ineffective, right, beta? Okay.
Yes.
The second thing is if I try to pull, right? The string is stretched now. And if I move my right hand towards right, can I move my left hand with it? Yes. I am able to transfer force with a stretched string. String is in tension and I am able to transfer the force. I am moving my right hand and with my right hand, this left hand has to move because string is applying force on left hand, right? So for this reason, string has to be always stretched in the condition, right? One more thing. Tension, there should always be, string can only support tension force, so string should always be in tension, right? The second thing, if the string is slacked, I am trying to move my right hand towards right, but up till a point, there is some point up till which there is no transfer of force, like this string is slacked and I am moving my right hand, but there is no motion on left hand side. First, the string will be stretched and then there is a transfer of force, right? So that's why string cannot be slacked in condition, because a slacked string cannot transfer forces. So string has to be massless and it has to be always stretched. These are two assumptions while we discuss about what string. It should be massless. We will write them. String should be massless and it should always be
stretched.
Right. So these are the two things. Now we understand ki tension in a string is a tensile force in string. So forces are always pulling in nature and they act away from the tied ends. Away from the tied end means, as I showed you, this is my left hand. Assume A as my left hand and B as my right hand. And there is a string connecting these two blocks, right? Now I am moving, I am applying a force, external force on block number B. Right, beta? So what will be the direction of force in the string? This block B will try to pull the string towards right and the string will try to pull this block B towards left, action and reaction pairs. Okay.
Yes,
so the force will be in the left hand side in the string. Again, this block A is applying a force on left side and block string has to apply a force on right side. So this is how we show tension in the string, right? Tension in the string is showed like this. So this is the standard notation for tension in the string. So always acts away from the tied ends. So these are the tied ends. Now the first one is this one and the second one is this one. So the tension force will act always away from the tied end. Okay, we discussed the type of forces, contact forces and tension in the string. These are sufficient for solving the problems of NLM. Now we come back to the concept of laws of motion. There are two laws of motion, two or three, beta? How many laws of motion are there?
Three.
ठीक है. Newton laws of motion, there are three laws of motion. The first one is qualitative. First one gives us the qualitative aspect of force. Second one gives us quantitative and third one says that single force cannot exist in nature, right? So we will read all the three laws of motion one by one. The first one says that qualitative aspect of force means there is something called as force, है ना? Force नाम की कोई चीज होती है, बस ये बताएगा. फर्स्ट लॉ क्या बोलेगा? देर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज फोर्स एंड फोर्स इज यूज टू चेंज द स्टेट ऑफ इनर्शिया. फोर्स इज समथिंग विच इज यूज टू चेंज द स्टेट ऑफ इनर्शिया ऑफ अ बॉडी, राइट? सो दिस इज फर्स्ट लॉ. सेकेंड लॉ सेज कि फर्स्ट लॉ ने बोला, फर्स्ट लॉ सेज कि फर्स्ट ने बोल दिया, सिंस फर्स्ट लॉ एस्टेब्लिश द कंसेप्ट ऑफ फोर्स, बट वट इज द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ फोर्स to bring about that change in the state of inertia, what is the magnitude of force? So second law quantifies that. Second law quantifies that this much amount of force is required to bring about a certain amount of acceleration in some object. Okay? So second law talks about quantity, magnitude. First law only talks about that force is required to change the state of inertia. Second law talks about what magnitude of force. And the third law says कि सिंगल फोर्स कैन नॉट एग्जिस्ट इन नेचर. तो क्या बोलते हैं थर्ड लॉ का सेकंड डेफिनेशन और दूसरा डेफिनेशन क्या है बेटा? कि टू एवरी एक्शन देयर इज एन इक्वल एंड अपोजिट रिएक्शन. टू एवरी एक्शन देयर इज इक्वल एंड अपोजिट रिएक्शन. ओके, सो टू एवरी एक्शन देयर इज इक्वल एंड अपोजिट रिएक्शन मीन्स सपोज दिस इज अ पॉइंट, राइट बेटा? इफ आई ट्राई टू अप्लाई अ फोर्स ऑन दिस ब्लॉक, we can say that m is the mass of this point, huh? And I apply a force f on this mass. So what will be the magnitude of force applied by the mass? There will minus equal and f. opposite reaction force, like equal in magnitude and opposite in direction. So this minus same f. amount of force will be applied by block of mass m also, and this point mass will apply equal magnitude of force on the second body, right? Here it is becoming a little bit confusing, so I will draw it up in the form of blocks, right? This is block A and there is another block B placed alongside it, right beta? I say that block A is applying a force of 10 newton on block B. So what block B will do as a reactive force? Block B will also apply a force of
minus
10
newton.
10 newton. Magnitude wise it will be 10 newton, otherwise vector wise it will be minus 10. Direction alag ho jayega, right? So this is how forces will appear in nature. So to every action there is equal and opposite reaction. And third law says that single force cannot exist. Since there is action force, so there has to be any reaction force to it. So action and reaction always exist in pairs, right? So pair means one force or two force? Two forces. So that's why सिंगल फोर्स कैन नॉट एग्जिस्ट. सिंगल कभी एग्जिस्ट नहीं करेगा, ऑलवेज एक्शन रिएक्शन पेयर में एग्जिस्ट करेंगे, राइट? अब देखो फर्स्ट लॉ सेकेंड लॉ थर्ड लॉ को डिटेल में पढ़ते हैं. फर्स्ट लॉ हमें समझ आया कि फर्स्ट लॉ टॉक्स अबाउट द क्वालिटेटिव एस्पेक्ट ऑफ फोर्स. क्वालिटेटिव एस्पेक्ट ऑफ फोर्स मीन्स क्या बोलते हैं? क्या बोलते हैं बेटा क्वालिटेटिव एस्पेक्ट ऑफ फोर्स? मीन्स कि टू ब्रिंग अबाउट इन द चेंज ऑफ इनर्शिया, स्टेट ऑफ इनर्शिया को चेंज करने के लिए वी हैव टू अप्लाई फोर्स, राइट? ओके, इनर्शिया क्या होता है? इनर्शिया इज ऑफ थ्री टाइप्स, इनर्शिया ऑफ रेस्ट, इनर्शिया ऑफ मोशन एंड इनर्शिया ऑफ डायरेक्शन. तो इनर्शिया ऑफ रेस्ट डिफाइन कर रहा हूँ बेटा, ध्यान से सुनना अभी, कि एन ऑब्जेक्ट एट रेस्ट विल रिमेन एट रेस्ट अनलेस देर इज एन अनबैलेंस्ड एक्सटर्नल फोर्स इज अप्लाइड. ठीक है, जब yes. एक ऑब्जेक्ट रेस्ट पर है वो रेस्ट पर ही रहेगा. कब तक? तब तक कि उस पर बाहर से अनबैलेंस्ड एक्सटर्नल फोर्स अप्लाई ना कर दिया जाए. तो इनर्शिया ऑफ रेस्ट आ गया. इनर्शिया ऑफ मोशन सेज कि एन ऑब्जेक्ट इन मोशन, एन ऑब्जेक्ट इन यूनिफॉर्म मोशन, लाइक यूनिफॉर्म मोशन मीन्स वेलोसिटी इज कॉन्स्टेंट, एन ऑब्जेक्ट मूविंग विद कॉन्स्टेंट वेलोसिटी विल कंटिन्यू इट्स मोशन विद दैट यूनिफॉर्म वेलोसिटी अनलेस देर इज एन अनबैलेंस्ड एक्सटर्नल फोर्स इज अप्लाइड, राइट? कॉन्स्टेंट वेलोसिटी मीन्स बेटा कि देर इज नो एक्सेलरेशन, है ना? एक्सेलरेशन इज जीरो, एंड इफ एक्सेलरेशन इज जीरो दैट मीन्स एक्सटर्नल फोर्सेस आर जीरो, राइट? ओके, एंड द थर्ड लॉ सेज इनर्शिया ऑफ डायरेक्शन, एन ऑब्जेक्ट मूविंग इन अ स्ट्रेट लाइन विल मूव इन दैट स्ट्रेट लाइन अनलेस यू अप्लाई अ एक्सटर्नल फोर्स टू चेंज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मोशन, राइट? राइट और रॉन्ग बेटा? राइट. ठीक है, दीज आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ इनर्शियाज एंड टू ब्रिंग अबाउट एनी चेंज इन द स्टेट ऑफ इनर्शिया वी नीड टू अप्लाई फोर्स, बाहर से फोर्स लगाना पड़ेगा इन तीनों स्टेट ऑफ इनर्शिया को चेंज करने के लिए, एंड दिस इज व्हाट इज न्यूटन्स फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ मोशन. यस मिस बा,
कैन यू रिपीट द लास्ट वन, इनर्शिया ऑफ डायरेक्शन.
इनर्शिया ऑफ डायरेक्शन, राइट. एन ऑब्जेक्ट मूविंग इन अ स्ट्रेट लाइन विल कंटिन्यू इट्स मोशन इन स्ट्रेट लाइन अनलेस यू अप्लाई एक्सटर्नल फोर्स टू चेंज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मोशन, राइट.
यस सर.
व्हेन यू थ्रो अ बॉल, इफ आई थ्रो दिस बॉल, व्हाट इज द शेप ऑफ द पाथ फॉलोड बेटा? पैराबोलिक, राइट. दिस विल बी अ प्रोजेक्टाइल ना, सो इट विल फॉलो अ पैराबोलिक पाथ. बट वाई द डायरेक्शन इज चेंजिंग एट एवरी पॉइंट? बिकॉज देर इज कंटिन्यूअसली अ ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स अप्लाइड ऑन दिस थिंग. इफ देर इज नो ग्रेविटी, वट विल बी द पाथ? स्ट्रेट लाइन, राइट. सो इट विल फॉलो अ स्ट्रेट लाइन पाथ. तो टू ब्रिंग अबाउट एनी चेंज इन द स्टेट ऑफ इनर्शिया वी हैव टू अप्लाई एक्सटर्नल फोर्सेस. यस गायत्री.
सर कैन यू रिपीट इनर्शिया ऑफ फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ मोशन?
बेटा आई एम नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड, कैन यू आस्क इट अगेन?
कैन यू रिपीट इनर्शिया ऑफ फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ मोशन?
मिस बासिका, आर यू एबल टू हियर हर?
नो सर.
नो गायत्री, यू आर नॉट ऑडिबल बेटा. यू कैन जस्ट टाइप योर क्वेश्चन, आई कैन आंसर इट. सो टू ब्रिंग अबाउट एनी चेंज इन टू द स्टेट ऑफ इनर्शिया वी हैव टू अप्लाई फोर्स, एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड एज फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ मोशन. ओके, नाउ लुकिंग क्लोजर टू दीज थ्री डेफिनेशंस, इनर्शिया ऑफ रेस्ट, इनर्शिया ऑफ मोशन एंड इनर्शिया ऑफ डायरेक्शन, वी नो दैट वेलोसिटी इज अ वेक्टर क्वांटिटी. इट हैज सम मैग्नीट्यूड एंड अ डायरेक्शन अटैच्ड टू इट, राइट. रेस्ट मीन्स वॉट? वेलोसिटी इज
जीरो.
ओके, एंड इनर्शिया ऑफ यूनिफॉर्म मोशन मीन्स वेलोसिटी इज कॉन्स्टेंट. एंड इनर्शिया ऑफ डायरेक्शन मीन्स इफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज मूविंग कंटिन्यूअसली विद यूनिफॉर्म वेलोसिटी इन अ स्ट्रेट लाइन मीन्स दैट मीन्स वेलोसिटी इज ऑल्सो कॉन्स्टेंट बेटा, कॉन्स्टेंट. डायरेक्शन इज इनर्शिया ऑफ डायरेक्शन मीन्स द ऑब्जेक्ट विल ट्राई टू कंटिन्यू इट्स मोशन इन स्ट्रेट लाइन, सो वेलोसिटी इज नॉट चेंजिंग इन दैट केस, राइट. सो इन ऑल दीज थ्री केसेस आइदर द वेलोसिटी इज जीरो और कॉन्स्टेंट और कॉन्स्टेंट. सो टू ब्रिंग अबाउट एनी चेंज इन द वेलोसिटी इन द स्टेट ऑफ इनर्शिया वी हैव टू चेंज व्हाट? वेलोसिटी. इफ आई चेंज द वेलोसिटी दैट मीन्स आई हैव ब्रॉट अबाउट अ चेंज इन द स्टेट ऑफ इनर्शिया. इफ समथिंग इज एट रेस्ट आई अप्लाई फोर्स सो इट विल स्टार्ट मूविंग, सो वेलोसिटी विल बिकम नॉन जीरो, सो वी हैव चेंज द वेलोसिटी. सेकेंड केस देखो, इनर्शिया ऑफ मोशन, इफ द वेलोसिटी इज कॉन्स्टेंट आई अप्लाई फोर्स देन द वेलोसिटी विल आइदर इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज, राइट. If the object is moving in a straight line and I need to change the direction of motion, I have to apply force. And if the direction changes, that means also velocity changes.
Changes.
Since it's a vector quantity. So to bring about change in velocity, we have to apply force.
Force.
And change in velocity means acceleration is zero or non-zero?
Acceleration is non-zero.
Acceleration is non-zero. And that establishes the foundation for second law, that what is force is equal to mass into acceleration,
mass into acceleration.
Right beta, can mass be zero? If there is a particle, can the mass be zero? No,
no sir.
Small ho sakta hai mass, mass can have a small value, but mass cannot be a zero. So mass is non-zero. And acceleration, since we have to bring about in the change of inertia, स्टेट ऑफ इनर्शिया में हमें चेंज करना है, तो वी हैव टू चेंज द वेलोसिटी, एंड फॉर चेंज इन वेलोसिटी एक्सेलरेशन आल्सो हैव टू बी नॉन जीरो, एंड फॉर दैट, फॉर नॉन जीरो मास, नॉन जीरो एक्सेलरेशन, वी हैव टू अप्लाई अ फोर्स व्हिच इज आल्सो गोइंग टू बी नॉन जीरो. सो फोर्स इज इक्वल टू मास इनटू एक्सेलरेशन, एंड दिस इज नथिंग बट व्हिच लॉ? सेकंड लॉ.
सेकंड लॉ,
राइट. So first law said that to bring about the change in the state of inertia, we have to apply force, and to quantify ki what magnitude of force is required, we go to second law. So let's proceed to second law. Second law says that force is equal to mass into acceleration. Right, beta? This we all know. Force is equal to mass into acceleration. But there is something called as force is also equal to rate of change of पी, व्हाट इज दिस पी?
मोमेंटम.
लीनियर मोमेंटम बेटा, ठीक है. पी इज लीनियर मोमेंटम एंड एल इज एंगुलर मोमेंटम. सो पी इज लीनियर मोमेंटम. सो अप्लाइड फोर्स इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ लीनियर मोमेंटम. सो पी इज अ वेक्टर क्वांटिटी और स्केलर क्वांटिटी? स्केलर वेक्टर क्वांटिटी. पी इज लीनियर मोमेंटम एंड मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ लीनियर मोमेंटम इज इक्वल टू एम टाइम्स वी. एम इन टू वी. वी इज वेलोसिटी, एम इज मास. ओके, अब व्हाट सेकेंड लॉ सेज कि डी पी बाई डी टी इज इक्वल टू फोर्स. मास इज कॉन्स्टेंट फॉर अ गिवन पार्टिकल. मास इज कॉन्स्टेंट. सो वट आई विल टेक मास आई विल ब्रिंग आउट ऑफ डिफरेंशिएशन एंड देन आई विल डिफरेंशिएट वेलोसिटी वैक्टर विद रिस्पेक्ट टू टाइम. वी नो दैट डी वी बाई डी टी इज वॉट? डी वी बाई डी टी इज
एक्सेलरेशन.
एक्सेलरेशन, ठीक है. सो इट इज एम वी, ठीक है बेटा. सो वी रिप्लेस डी वी बाई डी टी बाई एक्सेलरेशन एंड देन वट वी कैन से एम इज एम ए इज इक्वल टू फोर्स.
फोर्स,
सो इट इज प्रूवन दैट फोर्स इज नथिंग बट डी पी बाई डी टी. फोर्स क्या होगा? रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ लीनियर मोमेंटम होगा. डी पी बाई डी टी, राइट. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो सेकेंड लॉ ऑफ मोशन. क्या? कि फोर्स इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ लीनियर मोमेंटम. सो दिस इज न्यूटन सेकेंड लॉ ऑफ मोशन विच क्वान्टिफाइज कि वट मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ फोर्स इज रिक्वायर्ड टू ब्रिंग अबाउट अ सर्टेन वैल्यू ऑफ एक्सेलरेशन. ठीक है बेटा. सो दिस इज सेकेंड लॉ. अभी डाउट देखते हैं गायत्री ने क्या पूछा था. कैन यू रिपीट द इनर्शिया ऑफ मोशन एंड रेस्ट? ओके, ओके. सो इनर्शिया ऑफ रेस्ट बेटा ध्यान से सुनना गायत्री. इनर्शिया ऑफ रेस्ट, शिखा कैन यू हेल्प हर आउट? शिखा आप बताओ बेटा, व्हाट इज इनर्शिया ऑफ रेस्ट?
यस सर, अ बॉडी एट रेस्ट रिमेंस एट रेस्ट अंटिल एंड अनलेस एन एक्सटर्नल फोर्स इज अप्लाइड ऑन इट.
ओके, आपने थोड़ा सा हल्का सा मिस्टेक कर दिया. अब इनर्शिया ऑफ मोशन बताते टाइम उसी को रिवाइज करना. फोर्स के लिए अनलेस एंड अंटिल देयर इज अनबैलेंस्ड एक्सटर्नल फोर्स, है ना. अब बताओ मोशन इनर्शिया, बताओ इनर्शिया ऑफ मोशन.
एन ऑब्जेक्ट इन मोशन रिमेंस इन मोशन अंटिल एंड अनलेस एन अनबैलेंस्ड फोर्स इज अप्लाइड ऑन इट.
राइट, अभी देखो मैं बताता हूँ, सब सुनना. शिखा आप भी सुनना, मिशबा, गायत्री, जेनिफर, राइट. अब सुनो, इनर्शिया ऑफ रेस्ट क्या होगा? एन ऑब्जेक्ट और अ बॉडी एट रेस्ट विल रिमेन एट रेस्ट अनलेस एंड अनटिल देयर इज एन अनबैलेंस्ड एक्सटर्नल फोर्स इज अप्लाइड ऑन इट. सो फोर्स हैज टू बी अनबैलेंस्ड. अभी बताऊंगा अनबैलेंस्ड फोर्स क्या होता है, राइट. इनर्शिया ऑफ मोशन सेज दैट एन ऑब्जेक्ट इन यूनिफॉर्म मोशन विल कंटिन्यू इट्स मोशन इन यूनिफॉर्म विद यूनिफॉर्म वेलोसिटी अनलेस एंड अनटिल देयर इज एन अनबैलेंस्ड एक्सटर्नल फोर्स इज अप्लाइड. ठीक है, बाहर से अनबैलेंस्ड एक्सटर्नल फोर्स लगने पर ही रुकी हुई वस्तुएं चलना स्टार्ट करती हैं और चलती हुई वस्तुएं रुकना स्टार्ट करती है. ठीक है, अब देखो अनबैलेंस्ड फोर्स क्या होगा बेटा. सपोज देयर इज अ ब्लॉक ए, आई अप्लाई अ फोर्स फ्रॉम लेफ्ट साइड इन द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ फोर्स इज 100 न्यूटन्स. ठीक है बेटा, एंड देयर इज एन अनदर फोर्स दैट आई अप्लाई फ्रॉम राइट हैंड साइड एंड द मैग्नीट्यूड इज 100 न्यूटन्स. सो व्हाट इज द नेट फोर्स ऑन दिस ब्लॉक ए?
जीरो.
सो दीज टू फोर्सेज विल कैंसिल आउट ईच अदर. सो इफ आई आस्क यू व्हाट इज अनबैलेंस्ड एक्सटर्नल फोर्स, व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ 100 न्यूटन इज दिस ब्लू कलर 100 न्यूटन इज एक्सटर्नल फोर्स फॉर ब्लॉक ए? यस. एंड येलो कलर 100 न्यूटन फोर्स इज ऑल्सो एक्सटर्नल फोर्स? यस. बट सिंस दीज टू फोर्सेज आर कैंसिलिंग आउट ईच अदर, कैन वी से दैट देर इज सम अनबैलेंस्ड फोर्स?
नो सर.
नो नो बेटा नो, बिकॉज 100 न्यूटन एंड 100 न्यूटन विल कैंसिल आउट ईच अदर, ये एक दूसरे को कैंसिल आउट कर देंगे. सो अनबैलेंस्ड एक्सटर्नल फोर्स क्या हुआ? जीरो. बैलेंस हो गया ना, 100 इज कैंसिलिंग आउट 100 कम्प्लीटली. ओके, नाउ व्हाट आई मेक सम चेंज, आई विल मेक इट 400. नाउ व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ अनबैलेंस्ड एक्सटर्नल फोर्स? अनबैलेंस्ड एक्सटर्नल फोर्स इज एफ नेट. एफ नेट, राइट. सो एफ नेट इज नथिंग बट 300 न्यूटन इन द आई कैप डायरेक्शन. ठीक है, राइट साइड में 300 न्यूटन. सो एफ नेट इज नथिंग बट एफ नेट इज अनबैलेंस्ड फोर्स एंड दैट इज 300 न्यूटन. यस और नो बेटा?
यस सर.
यस ठीक है ओके वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सेकेंड लॉ नाउ सॉल्व दिस लिटिल प्रॉब्लम फॉर मी सो वी ऑलरेडी नो द आंसर फ्रॉम हियर जस्ट सॉल्व इट वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मोमेंटम वेक्टर लीनियर मोमेंटम वेक्टर का डायरेक्शन फाइंड आउट करना है सॉल्व दिस वन आगे आंसर बेटा
ऑप्शन
बताओ
है
ऑप्शन ए बाकी बच्चे भी सॉल्व करो यार ओके मिसबा आप सॉल्यूशन समझाओ बेटा हाउ यू सॉल्व दिस वन
साइड ऑफ लीनियर मोमेंटम इज इक्वल टू एम इंटू वी इक्वल टू 10 आई कैप प्लस 5 जे कैप
ओके
देन आई टू 10 थीटा इज इक्वल टू वाई बाय एक्स
ओके
इज इक्वल टू 5/10 देन आई डिड द कैलकुलेशन
सो वी कैलकुलेटेड लीनियर मोमेंटम बाय एम इंटू वी राइट एंड दैट इज इक्वल टू वन इंटू मास का वैल्यू वन दिया इंटू 10 i कैप प्लस 5 j कैप सो वट विल बी द मोमेंटम वैक्टर बेटा 10 i कैप प्लस 5 j कैप कैन आई प्लॉट दिस वैक्टर यस इन आई कैप डायरेक्शन एंड इन जे कैप डायरेक्शन वट इज द मैग्नीट्यूड इन आई कैप डायरेक्शन बेटा 10 units
10
And then what is the magnitude in J cap direction?
5.
5. Can I draw this vector in this way? This is the momentum vector.
Yes, sir.
I need to find out direction of this momentum vector. How can I find out direction of vector with x axis? By finding out the value of this theta. If I provide you that theta is theta value, then I can say that momentum vector is at an angle of theta with x axis or i cap direction. Theek hai beta? Okay. So can we use tangent theta into this triangle?
Perpendicular.
Tan theta is equal to perpendicular by base. Five divided by 10. Okay. What we will do now? It will be 1 by 2.
Inverse equals to 1
theta
by
is equal to tan inverse of 1 by 2 and that is equal to our answer A. Gayatri, you understood beta?
Yes sir.
Gayatri. Okay.
Yes sir.
ओके, यू स्टार्ट द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन. दिस इज बेस्ड अपॉन एफ नेट. बेटा ट्राई टू सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन.
सर
आ गया बेटा आंसर? ओके,
नो सर
डाउट है?
यस सर
ओके आस्क.
यस सर फर्स्ट फोर्स इज आई कैप डायरेक्शन एंड सेकंड जे कैप देन द थर्ड वन इज के कैप.
नो 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 शिकाई, आर यू ट्राइंग?
यस सर
जस्ट ट्राई इट फॉर अनदर 1 मिनट एंड देन आई विल गिव यू द हिंट, देन वी कैन सॉल्व इट इजीली. इट्स अ वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन बेटा. Have you solved, Sika?
Yes, sir. My answer is 18 I cap plus 24 j cap equals to minus 16.
रुको अभी कराते हैं. आपका आंसर थोड़ा सा गलत है, थोड़ा सा पार्टली सही है, पार्टली गलत. अभी कराते हैं. सो आई विल गिव यू हिंट फर्स्ट, राइट? देन यू विल सॉल्व इट फॉर मी. We know that from Newton's second law, we know that force is equal to F net is equal to unbalanced external force means F net. That is equal to mass into acceleration beta.
Acceleration.
What is the value of mass given in the question?
2 kg.
2.
2. And what is the value of acceleration?
-8 i cap.
Minus 8 i cap. So minus 8 i cap. So what is the value of force? F net force is minus 16 in the i cap direction, right beta? And what will be this F net? F net will be nothing but summation of all the forces, na? F1 plus F2 and F3.
Yes,
suppose
sir.
The third force is F3, So if I add all these three forces, what I will reach? I will reach
F
to F net,
net.
right? So I can write F net is equal to F1 plus F2 plus
That's
F3,
F3.
And all in the vector form with all the directions, right? Miss Bar, just understand this thing. Suppose there is an object, right? And there are three forces acting on it. F1 in this direction, F2 in this direction, and maybe F3 in some other direction, right? The magnitude are different. So I am trying to find out F net, net force, and which will bring about some acceleration into this block of 2 kg, right? So F net is nothing but vector sum of F1 plus F2 plus F3. ठीक है बेटा?
Yes.
I know that F1 is given in the question, F2 is also given in the question. I will assume that let F3 be x in I cap direction and y in j cap direction, right? So what I will do, I
yes,
will
sir.
Put the value of F net as minus 16 I cap, which I have solved here. जो मैंने यहाँ पे solve कर लिया. Then equals to F1. What is the value of F1 given in the question?
30
I cap direction, 16 in
16
J cap. ठीक है बेटा. What is the value of F2 given?
Minus 12 I cap plus 8 J cap.
Minus 12 I cap plus 8 J cap, right? And what is F3?
X i cap plus y j cap.
Now I can calculate in individual direction, I direction individually and then j direction. So I will take only the components which are in I cap direction. So on the left hand side, what is there? Minus 16. On the right hand side, 30, minus 12, and
yes, sir.
x. Now I can solve it for x. What will be the value of x? X is equal to minus 16 minus 30 plus 12. So it will be minus 34.
Yes, sir.
Right? So value of x is minus 34.
Minus 34.
What is the value of y? I will be solving for y. So is there any j cap component on left hand side of the equality?
No, sir.
No. So what I will take? Zero.
Yes, sir.
Right, zero. Yeah. I can take zero, na? So zero is equal to 16 plus 8 and plus y. Solving this thing will give y is equal to minus 24. Right?
Yes, sir.
I have found out value of x and y. So can I write value of F3?
Yes.
What
sir.
Is the value of x? Minus 34 in I cap direction. And what is the value of y? Minus 24 in
minus
J cap direction. So what is the value of F3? The third force is minus 34 I cap minus 24 J cap. Have you understood it now, Gayatri?
Yes, sir.
Shikha, Misba?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Right. Okay. So if you have any doubt, we can stay for the doubts in our today's lecture. Otherwise, we will start it from third law of motion in the next class. Theek hai beta? We'll start the third law of motion and lot many problems based upon the third law. So you can ask your doubt from first law, second law, or maybe motion in 1D. If you have any doubts till now, you can ask. So you have a test on Sunday, है ना? There is a test based upon what? M1D. Motion in 1D has to be covered. So you need to revise that from the notes that I've already shared in the group. I will share the short notes today again. You use both the resources, the class notes and the short notes to revise the chapter and appear for the test very sincerely better, right? So revise it and try to solve the questions in the exam. On Saturday, we will keep a revision session also. So in that way, we will be able to complete one unit, which is M1D, right? Then we will complete this Newton laws of motion, work, power, energy, you know, and friction. We will do all these things. in our bridge curriculum, then we will proceed to our 12th class ka syllabus and then come back to 11th if the time permits again, right? So M1D, you need to revise it thoroughly, solve all the question, read the class notes line by line, and try to recapitulate. If you have any doubt, you can always ask me in the classes, and then we will write our exam. It will be an online exam, just like based upon the NEET pattern, and it will give you an insight into your learnings, right? So there is nothing to be feared about the exam. There is nothing to be very too much conscious about that thing. Just go write the exam with a good preparation and a cool mind, and eventually the things will work out at the end of the year. You know, at the end of our preparation, you will be selected. Good to go, beta. Okay, you have any doubts for today's class?
No, sir.
Gayatri?
No, sir.
Should I ask you some questions?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Gayatri, tell me, what are the two assumptions while we were discussing string? What are the two assumptions for a string to be effective?
If when the string is slack, if we move the there is no force in our right answer, but the force is just when we apply force on the right, the force will be on the left, sir. So the string is in motionless and stretched.
ओके सीखा यू विल ट्राई बेटा
यस सर
या
दिस स्ट्रिंग इज मासलेस
हाँ
एंड दिस स्ट्रिंग शुड बी स्ट्रेच्ड
राइट फॉर द स्ट्रिंग टू बी इफेक्टिव राइट सो टू ट्रांसफर एनी फोर्स यूजिंग अ स्ट्रिंग द स्ट्रिंग हैज टू बी मासलेस एंड द स्ट्रिंग हैज टू बी स्ट्रेच्ड व्हाई मासलेस बिकॉज इफ द स्ट्रिंग हैज सम मास ऑफ इट्स ओन ना सो द इक्वेशन विल बी सम वी हैव टू यूज सम डिफरेंट इक्वेशंस व्हिच आर आउट ऑफ आवर सिलेबस दैट्स व्हाई वी अज्यूम द स्ट्रिंग इज मासलेस एंड इट हैज टू बी स्ट्रेच्ड टू ट्रांसफर फोर्सेस फ्रॉम वन बॉडी टू अनदर राइट मिस बा वुड यू ट्राई बेटा मिस बा
Slack and string cannot transfer force.
या स्लैक द स्ट्रिंग कैन नॉट ट्रांसफर फोर्स फ्रॉम ब्लॉक ए टू बी राइट ओके What are the two types of contact forces?
Normal force and friction
Normal
force.
force and friction.
You can unmute yourself, not since you very few students, I can hear your answers. You can unmute and just keep on. What is force? How we define force, beta?
A push or pull change or tends to change the state of motion.
Okay.
Push or
Can
pull
you
that
give
changes
me
the
an
speed.
example where the force,
Speed of
can you
motion.
give an example apart from what we have discussed? Then I have given you two examples. Can you think of some third example where a force is trying to, it is tending to change the state of motion when the force is tending to change, but it is not actually changing. Can you think of some third example, beta?
Pushing a door.
Pushing a
Door or a wall.
Pushing a wall, exactly. Yes. Misbah, can you give me a fourth example, beta?
Pushing a car.
Pushing a car, and if you pushing a car does not necessarily move it every time, so it can be an example, right? Okay. Now, okay, we will come back to Newton first law. Okay, Misbah, you try. What is Newton first law?
An object will remain at rest or in uniform motion unless the unbalanced external force applied to it.
ओके ग्रेट ग्रेट शिखा आप बताइए बेटा व्हाट आर द थ्री स्टेट्स ऑफ इनर्शिया
इनर्शिया ऑफ रेस्ट, इनर्शिया ऑफ मोशन एंड इनर्शिया ऑफ डायरेक्शन.
एग्जैक्टली राइट राइट नाउ कमिंग टू ओके व्हाट इज द मेजर डिफरेंस बिटवीन न्यूटन्स फर्स्ट लॉ एंड सेकंड लॉ शिखा
First law gives the qualitative definition of force, and the second one gives the quantitative.
Quantitative. It will define the quantity of force required to bring about any change in the state of inertia. Right. Okay. So, Misbah, will you try that? How force is equal to change in is equal to rate of change of linear momentum? How we can say that? वाई फोर्स इज इक्वल टू रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ लीनियर मोमेंटम, वाई फोर्स इज इक्वल टू डी पी बाई डी टी.
तो बिकॉज लीनियर मोमेंटम इज इक्वल टू मास इनटू वेलोसिटी.
यस.
एंड द सेकंड इक्वेशन इज डी पी बाई डी टी इज इक्वल टू डी वी बाई डी टी.
राइट. So we dv by dt is equal to acceleration and mass times acceleration we know from second law it is equal to force.
Okay.
I will ask one more question, an open question from errors chapter, right? Equality of dimensions. You know that concept, beta?
Yes, sir.
Misbah, you know it? Yes. So equality of dimensions. So on the both side of equality, on the both side of equal to sign, the dimensions should be
equal. Same.
The dimensions should be, yeah, same. What is the dimensional formula for mass? M. As simple as that. And what is the dimensional formula for acceleration, beta? Shikha.
Lt minus 2.
Lt minus 2. Miss Bhai, you know it na, beta?
Yes, sir.
Meter, meter per second square, so Lt minus 2. So how, what will be the dimensional formula of force using the
m1 l1 t minus 2
m1 l1 t minus 2 because dimensional homogeneity, principle of homogeneity of dimensions says that on the both side of equality dimension should be equal. So we know that dimension of mass is m1 and dimension of acceleration is l1 t minus 2. So definitely the force ka dimension has to be m1 l1 t minus 2. Right or wrong? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can we give a, can you give me the dimensions of linear momentum also, beta? Mishba.
M1 of for M and for V LT minus 1.
LT minus 1, right. So what will be the dimensions of linear momentum? It will be
m1 l1 t minus 1,
right? We know that force is equal to delta p by delta t. Aisa bol dena, right? So dimensional formula of p is equal to m1 l1 t minus 1. So can we write it like this, m1 l1 t minus 1 and divided by dimensions of time
t1.
Right. So T1 will go in numerator. So it will turn out to be M1 L1 T minus
E minus 2.
So everything is correct so far we have learned. Right? So it also brings about a affirmation to what we have learned, that force is nothing but rate of change of linear momentum. It is also equal to mass times acceleration, since dimensional homogeneity ka principle approves our findings or our learnings. Yes, beta?
Yes, sir.
ठीक है. एनी अदर डाउट्स बेटा? ओके, चलो कैन वी कंक्लूड अवर क्लास? और पढ़ा दूं अभी?